Honorable Member C. H. Vasantha Kumar.
Respected Speaker sir, thank you very much for allowing me to participate in a very important and sensitive issue. Water is precious and is a necessity to each and everyone. In a large country like ours, there are large and small rivers spread throughout the country. In many parts, there is also a threat of floods, and in other parts, there is always a drought-like situation exists. The government of the day has to spend thousands of crores of rupees to contain floods and to extend financial assistance in case of drought every year. Unfortunately, maybe due to circumstances beyond control, the major rivers of the country could not be linked. Had this been linked, government would not have to spend on floods and droughts. The government should consider linking major rivers with other rivers on war footing basis. Moreover, when the rivers are linked, there should be a way of transport, that is, waterways. Mr. Speaker, sir, already there are many interstate river issues being under different tribunals. With the passing of this bill, I urge upon the government to sort out all the pending issues within a time frame on war footing basis. Moreover, when a tribunal is formed, it should be ensured that at least one person should be a member from the affected area. Sir, recently it has been seen that the awards given by the tribunals are not at all implemented by the state government, or the awards are delayed by the state. I want to know from the government what is the mechanism available with the government to ensure that the awards are implemented. There should be some deterrent factor to ensure that the awards are implemented, otherwise this tribunal is another farce. Especially it has been in the Kaveri water issue, Karnataka government delayed release of water on many occasions. There are certain interstate water issues between Tamil Nadu and Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. It is a very interesting fact that all the states are Dravidian states and have close-knit relationship, especially even in marriages. When a state refuses water to another state within the Dravidian state, it means that the state refusing water to their own children and relatives. In my MLA tenure in the state of Tamil Nadu, I was initiated through the former Chief Minister Dr. Kalanjar Karunanidhi, interlink of rivers in the state Tamaravarani, Karmeniyaru, Nambiyar by excavating a new flood carrier canal. The project has been proposed to utilize 2,765 million cubic feet of water out of the 13,758 million cubic feet of water that flows to the sea as surplus water from Tamaravarani during the flood situation. The cost appraisal for this project is 872 crore. Through this project, more than 60,000 acres benefited. There is a provision for setting up of a permanent tribunal to resolve inter-state water disputes. However, there is another provision for establishment of a dispute resolution committee by the central government for resolving amicably the interstate water dispute within a maximum period of 1 year and 6 months. Moreover, any dispute which cannot be settled by negotiations shall be referred to the tribunal for its judicization. But I have some reservations. The dispute resolution committee may take a longer time than the time limit prescribed under the law, as there is every livelihood of giving extension after extension in the name of negotiation, and the case will be pending for so long without being resolved. I appeal to the government to cut short the time limit of 1.5 years to 6 months only, and ensure that no extension is given on any accounts. Moreover, the award being implemented by the tribunal should be implemented, and the government should ensure the implementation. I take the opportunity to focus attention of the government regarding the Mullaiperiyar Kaveri water issues. Though the tribunal has given us its award, the Karnataka government never releases water from the Kaveri, and every time the court has to be approached. I want to demand from the government why this is happening. Why not have an automatic mechanism to implement once the award is given by the tribunal? The government should ensure this. Neyyar River left bank canal will help to irrigation an area of 9,200 acres in Vilavankot Taluka in Kanyakumari. In 2012, Tamil Nadu government filed a petition against Kerala government seeking uninterrupted water supply from Neyyar River, and the matter is now pending in Supreme Court. The Tamil Nadu government has contended that the Neyyar is an interstate river because a portion of the river's catchment area lies in the territory of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu.
The matter is pending before the Supreme Court and it is sub judice.
So far the court has not directed.
The state remains because in the state because a portion of the river catchment area lies in the territory of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu government has not received water since 2004, which has caused serious hardship to the farming community.
Yes.
Previously, in 1999, the Kerala government took a stand that Neyyar was not an interstate river.
Yes.
However, in its own draft agreement, Kerala informed Tamil Nadu in 2010 that the water shall be supplied subject to the realization of water charges.
Yes.
Water charges and payment of distribution. Payment of distribution charges and make the agreement valid for 5 years to be renewed by the mutual consent. The Supreme Court in November 2016 had framed certain issues, including whether the river can be classified as an interstate river and also whether the legal obligation is imposed on the Kerala government to supply water from Neyyar to Kanyakumari under the State Reorganization Act 1956. The matter is pending in Supreme Court now. I am also accepting in Supreme Court. I request the central government to ensure water supply from Neyyar to Neyyar to Kanyakumari to help farmers in the district for irrigation purpose. The government is very well aware that loans from banks and agriculture purpose, and even for personal commitments like children's education, medical expenses, marriage, etc. Farmers are not able to grow any crops and they are not able to repay the loans borrowed from banks and other private agencies. If the state government does not meet its commitment, for releasing water to another state,
yes,
and because of this the farmers that states are affected, then the state government, which has to release water, has to pay compensation because of the loss suffered by farmers. Central government should also contribute their share in the compensation. The central government should ensure that the concerned state government give compensation to farmers, and in case the state government does not pay the compensation, the amount to payable shall be deducted by the central government while allocation is being made to the concerned state payment out of the central fund.
Yes.
Speaker sir,
please.
The river water dispute are more in southern parts of the country than any other. 2 minutes. When the government was formed in May, the Honorable Minister for Transport Highways, Mr. Nitin Gadkari, made a statement that Godavari, Krishna will be linked with Kaveri for the benefit of Tamil Nadu. In these rivers are linked, then I am sure the dispute of interstate rivers will be reduced considerably. But the announcement should concrete steps to the implement the project. That to sum up, I urge upon the government willing all the rivers to resolve interstate water dispute. I request the government, 1 second. I request the government to solve the Neyyar River, Kanyakumari. I request the government to solve the Neyyar River dispute at the alias, which would benefit of Kanyakumari constituency. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Thank you.